Dear friend, welcome to the lecture series in antennas and wave propagation. In this video lecture, we are going to learn about Friis transmission formula. Coming to the Friis transmission formula or radio communication link, the concept of aperture is useful in deriving Friis transmission formula or radio communication link. Let us consider lossless matched transmitting and receiving antennas. So here we have the transmitting antenna section. So the transmitting antenna gain is GT, effective aperture is AET. Coming to the receiver antenna section, the receiving antenna gain is GR and effective aperture is AER. These two antennas are at the distance of R, and the signal will be transmitted and received between the transmitter and receiver sections. Let the transmitted feed a power PT to a transmitting antenna of effective aperture AET. At distance R, a receiving antenna with effective aperture AER receives some of the power radiated by the transmitting antenna. The received power, which is part of the radiated power by the transmitter, is delivered to the receiver. Assuming the transmitting antenna as an isotropic antenna, the power per unit area available at the receiving antenna is given by SR equal to PT by 4 pi R square. If the transmitting antenna has a gain GT, the power per unit area available at the receiving antenna will be increased in proportion. So SR will be equal to PT GT by 4 pi R square. Now the power received by the receiving antenna with effective aperture AER is PR equal to SR into AER. Now substituting the value of SR in the expression, we will be getting PR will be equal to PT GT AER by 4 pi R square. The gain of the antenna GT can be expressed as GT equal to 4 pi AET by lambda square. Therefore, substituting GT in the power received expression, that is PR, we get PR will be equal to PT multiplied with 4 pi AET by lambda square AER by 4 pi R square. Now simplifying this expression, PR will be equal to PT AET AER by R square lambda square in watts. Now taking the PT towards the left side in the denominator, so PR PT will be equal to AET AER by R square lambda square. Now this expression is called as Friis transmission formula, which is a dimensionless quantity. So here let us look at the various terms that appears in Friis transmission formula. R is the distance between the antennas in meters. Lambda is the wavelength in meters. PR is the power received in watt. PT is the power transmitted in watt. AET is the effective aperture of the transmitting antenna. AER is the effective aperture of the receiving antenna. Both the quantities will be measured in meter square. To express power received in terms of transmitting and receiving antenna gains, so here working with PR equal to PT GT AER by 4 pi R square, we know that AER will be equal to GR by lambda square 4 pi. We can get this particular expression from this. We know D equal to 4 pi lambda square AE. That is, it is the expression that shows between the directivity and effective aperture of the antenna. Now the gain and directivity of the antenna D will be associated as G equal to eta D, where eta is the efficiency of the antenna. If the antenna efficiency is 100%, then the gain will be equal to the directivity of the antenna. So here G can be written as 4 pi lambda square AE from this particular expression. So here writing AE will be equal to G lambda square by 4 pi. So now we are writing this particular expression for the receiving antenna so that AE becomes AER, G becomes GR. So here we got AER will be equal to GR lambda square by 4 pi. Therefore, the received power in terms of antenna gains, PR will be equal to PT GT GR lambda square by 4 pi over 4 pi R square. Simplifying this particular expression, we get PR will be equal to PT GT GR lambda by 4 pi R whole square in watts. Here, GT is the gain of the transmitting antenna. GR is the gain of the receiving antenna. Let us look at a numerical problem on the Friis transmission formula. So the problem says a communication link is to be established between two stations using half wavelength antenna for maximum directive gain. Transmitter power is 1 kilowatt. Distance between transmitter and receiver is 100 kilometer. What is the maximum power received by receiver if frequency of operation is 100 megahertz? Go to the solution. Let us write the given data. The given data consisting of power transmitted, that is 1 kilowatt, distance between the transmitter and receiver, that is R, which is given by 100 kilometer. Frequency of operation F is given, that is 100 megahertz. And here one hint is provided, that is the transmitting and receiving antennas are half wave dipoles. So for the half wave dipoles, the maximum directive gain is written as 1.64. To be found is what could be the power received by the receiving antenna. The formulas to be used here are PR equal to PT GT GR multiplied with lambda by 4 pi R whole square in watts. Now writing the gain of the transmitting antenna, receiving antenna in terms of the maximum directive gains of the transmitting antenna and receiving antenna, we will be getting PR will be equal to PT GD max of transmitting antenna, GD max of receiving antenna multiplied with lambda by 4 pi R whole square in watts. Now, in this expression, we don't know what is lambda. So for lambda, the lambda is related to the frequency of operation as C by F. So here the value of C is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. Now going to the calculation part. So lambda is equal to C by F. Substituting the values for C and F, we'll be getting the value as 3 meter. Now substituting all the values in PR. So PR will be equal to 1000 × 1.64 × 1.64 × 3/4 × 100 × 10⁻³² So we will be getting PR will be equal to 0.01533 × 10⁻⁶, representing 10⁻⁶ as micro. So the total received power will be PR will be equal to 0.01533 microwatts. So finally writing the result, the received power is PR, which is equal to 0.01533 microwatts. Now looking at one more numerical problem. So here the problem says a communication link has a 15 watt transmitter connected to an antenna of 2.5 meter square effective aperture at 5 gigahertz. The receiving antenna has an effective aperture of 0.5 meter square and is located at 15 kilometer line of sight distance from the transmitting antenna. Assuming lossless matched antennas, find the power delivered to the receiver. Coming to the solution, write the given data. So here the given data containing the following. So PT is the transmitting power, that is 15 watt. AET is the transmitting antenna effective aperture 2.5 meter square. AER is the receiving antenna effective aperture, that is 0.5 meter square. R is the distance between the transmitter and receiver, which is given by 15 kilometer. And F is the frequency of operation given as 5 gigahertz. Formula to be used is PR equal to PT AET AER by R square lambda square in watt. So here we don't know the lambda. So for lambda, we have to write C by F as the lambda is related to the frequency of operation in this manner. So here C is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. Coming to calculation, so lambda is equal to C by F. Substituting the values of C and F, we'll be getting the value as 0.06 in meters. Now, substituting all the values in PR expression. So here we'll be getting the PR value as 23 × 10⁻⁶. Writing 10⁻⁶ in micros. So the received power is 23 microwatt. Finally, writing the result, the received power is PR, which is equal to 23 microwatt. Hope you understood the video about the Friis transmission formula. Please do subscribe my channel and click the bell button so that you will be notified with the latest videos on antennas and wave propagation. Thanks for watching.